Bump and displacement, the easiest way to elevate your textures. But what is the difference between bump and displacement? And how do they work? I'm going to show you exactly that inside of this tutorial. Let's start off by adding an icosphere to scale it up a little bit. So first, let me talk about what bump is. If I'm going to add a new material, right now you can see our normal input in here. If I'm going to add a bump node, if we connect this bump node in here, any black and white texture I add in here, it is going to add it as a bump to that object. So for example, if I'm going to take a noise texture in here, preview it. Right now we have black and white values, right? So again, the concept I had talked about in this video, how 0 and 1 is linked to black and white. If I plug this into high and preview our bump, Control Shift left mouse button, you can see something is happening. And what it basically is doing is, it's creating a bump out of this noise texture. Wherever it has white values, it is projecting that part. So if I preview our material, this is how it looks. I'm going to add subdivisions by Control 2. So this is how it is looking right now. It added a bump basically. If I'm going to add a color ramp, plug it in here. Let's preview the color ramp. I'm going to crush the dark and bright values. So the bump becomes more obvious. Yeah, you can see right now what is happening. So what is happening right now is wherever it has white values, it is projecting that part. And wherever it has black values, it is doing nothing. So that is how bump works. And the advantage of bump is, it is not actually displacing the geometry itself. And because of that, it is pretty fast. But there is another method where we do change the geometry. So right now, if you look at this, the outer edges, you can see, even though the projections are there, the outline of the object hasn't changed at all. It is because it's mimicking the bump basically, and it is not distorting the geometry itself. But if I'm going to use a displacement, if I'm going to search for a displacement node, if I plug this into displacement and use this color into height, right now you can see nothing happen. So why is that? Right now you can see, like, if I remove the bump, it is the same as the bump. Like, nothing more has been added. The geometry isn't being displaced. So why is that? It is because I have to select the object. I have to go in here, come down into our settings. And right now you can see that displacement is set to bump only. We can either set it to displacement only or displacement and bump. I'm going to set it to displacement only for now. And right now something crazy just happened. And right now what is happening is that displacement is also altering the geometry itself. So if I'm going to come in here, either I can increase the subdivisions, or if I go into our render settings and change this to experimental. And right now you can see adaptive subdivision button in here. So if I'm going to click that, preview it, you can see it made it much smoother. I'm going to decrease the scale. So decrease the dicing scale a little bit. So the problem with this is, it is very, very system heavy. Like, if I'm going to rotate it, you can see it is not as smooth as using bump. But this is a more accurate way. Like, if I'm going to rotate it, you can see in the edges, the geometry is being displaced. So that is the difference between using a bump and a displacement. And again, instead of this, if I am going to use a wave texture, let's preview it. If I plug this into our color ramp, okay, it is making lines basically. If I plug this into height, preview our object, this is how it looks. Again, the reason why it is displacing is because of the 0 and 1 values. Wherever it's black, it is not displacing, and wherever it's white, it's completely displacing. And again, this is very, very system heavy, but it does give realistic results. So I hope you understand the difference between displacement and bump, and how to go into the settings and enable displacement for it to work properly.